Caleb's, one of his favourite stories was Scotty Swift almost killed a guy. I want to know more.
Oh my God. Right. Okay. Yeah, this is one of Caleb's favourite stories ever. And the great thing about the story is every time I tell it, it won't change because it's true and it happened. That's the beauty of telling the truth. The story won't change. So a friend of mine from back in the day, this must be 2004, maybe. It was 16 years ago, so I'm just a youngin. And a mate of mine called Richard, he started doing a DJ in like a club night in town. And it was, I think it was like a Wednesday night, so it wasn't going to be busy. So I said, I'll come along because it's going to be quiet and have someone there. So he played a couple of songs that I asked for. I had a good drink and a good night. Perfect. Leave the club maybe at one-ish. So we're walking through town, head back to his flat, play for a couple more drinks, whatever. I think I might have been at college at that time, so it must have been like a late start the next day. Ah, screw it, I'll have a drink. So we're walking through Union Street, which is the main city, the main street in Aberdeen, if you don't know. So we're walking through Union Street to head to King Street, which is one of the main roads. So we're walking along and we get to where there's a junction with the traffic lights on that street. And I can see some guy banging on a landing door, screaming and yelling. So we're like, okay, what's this? So he's about maybe 20 feet away from us. So we're going, okay, what's going to happen here? So we look up and out of the one of the living room windows, there's two girls screaming at the guy to like leave us alone, bugger off, whatever. So they're clearly distressed at this guy. I'm assuming this stranger who's banging to get in a landing door. These two girls are panicking and it's 1:30 in the morning. So we get close enough to him and then he clocks us. And I was like, come on, mate. No, they're clearly not happy with it. Let's just, that's enough. Leave him alone. So the guy, he's just, his eyes are rattling. So he's on something, whatever. So he comes up to me, he headbutts me, boom. But there's not much behind it. I'm just like, oh, did I get headbutted? He's grabbed Richard by the scruff of the jacket and he's thrown him onto the road. So luckily, it's 1:30 in the morning. It's a main road, but it's quiet, which is lucky because a car could have easily hit him. So at that point, I'm thinking, nah, I'm not having that. I clothesline him from behind and knock him to the floor. I put him in a crossface and then I'm wrenching on it and then I hear this and he just stops moving.
Jesus.
So I think, have I just killed a man? So let him go. He's there. He's on the deck, on the pavement. He's not moving. He's out. Look at Richard. Richard looks at me. We look up to the girls who are out the window, who are now, who've just seen this whole thing unfold. I look up to them and say, don't tell anyone. And we run. I don't know. My first thought was like, oh my God, what have I done? I just panicked and 1:30 in the morning, it's a whole thing. His flat wasn't far away from where we are, like a five minute walk, but it was a 2 minute run. So we run back and the whole time I'm thinking, God, have I killed someone? It's like, what happens if, like, no, what if I've broken his neck? What if, like, he just stopped moving? I heard a crack, he stopped moving. So, but 6 o'clock in the morning comes at Luke. I need to head back the way we came to see if this guy's still there. So I'm thinking I'm going to get around the corner and find this corpse laying there. And he's gone. There's a wee puddle of like mucus and blood. It's like, oh my God. Okay, well, he's up, he's mobile, he's away. Right. So make my way through Union Street again to go to a taxi rank to get a taxi home. And then as I'm walking to the rank, I see the guy. He's outside the hole in the wall taking money out. He sees me. So I think we're probably going to fight here. But a part of me is just like, I'm so glad you're alive. I'm so glad you're alive. I don't care if you beat the crap out of me. I'm just happy you're alive. He sees me, has no recognition on his face, doesn't recognize me at all, goes back to it, takes the money out, walks away. I go home, go to bed.